Good day, everyone. This is Mr. Arias, and I teach science at the Ateneo de Manila Junior High School. Last time, I posted a video about how to integrate OBS into your video conference lectures. And in this video, I showcase one of the key features of OBS, and that is the ability to shift between multiple scenes by the press of a hotkey. Now, there are much simpler recording apps out there, such as the built-in PowerPoint lecture recorder that is in the Microsoft PowerPoint app itself. However, OBS gives you the flexibility to expand beyond your own PowerPoint lectures into other apps that your computer may have. So for today, I will demonstrate 5 ways by which you can make your video lectures more engaging using the multiple scene feature of OBS. Here's how. Number 1. Image sources. Now, OBS has a very special feature that allows you to take any image in your computer and put them into your video lecture. And this kind of practice is not new to broadcasting. In fact, you see it a lot in sports games, wherein broadcasters would put, let's say, the scoreboard or statistics about the game or even pop-up advertisements at the bottom corner to enhance your viewing experience. When you're teaching, it's no different. Like for instance, when I'm teaching physics, we do a lot of problem solving. As such, we always need to bring up a certain equation whenever we're trying to teach the technical side of solving problems. And with the press of a hotkey, you could actually make these equations pop up at your beckon call. Aside from that, you could also do it when you're teaching chemistry, when let's say you have to refer to the periodic table. When you have this access to a hotkey, you can make it seem as if the student has an index card that they can actually refer to when they are solving these problems. Number 2. Apps. So aside from your default PowerPoint app, you could actually use OBS to show other apps that may be running in your computer. This can be very useful to expand the potential of your lectures beyond simply screenshots in a PowerPoint. Let's say you're a math teacher and you're solving problems in your video. You could actually get a calculator emulator, even one that looks like the actual calculator that the students use, and put that into your screen whenever you're solving problems. Or you could use this very unique opportunity to do gamification or integrating video games into the lectures. I've done it before, using Minecraft to demonstrate concepts in physics such as gravity and projectiles, and I'm sure that the students would really appreciate how hands-on your lectures could be if you can show the app window in itself. Number 3. Text files. In line with the idea of capturing the window of certain apps in your computer, you could also capture the window of certain PDF files or ebook versions of reference materials. And it would be very handy if you could just shift with the press of a hotkey from PowerPoint to the actual words on the text. And this could be very useful if, let's say, you're a literature or religion teacher. It would be very handy to just go from your lecture slides where you're discussing important points to the actual passages of the novel or the Bible that you are studying. Or when I'm teaching research, I could actually go to a scientific article or scientific journal and then explain and discuss this scientific journal by just pressing the hotkey. It would be very useful if you can make your lessons go directly into the references in themselves. Number 4. Browser. Schools going online will give us teachers a very unique opportunity in order to take our students even closer to the online world. OBS has a lot of key features that you can use to help, such as browser capture and even window capture of an existing window of an internet browser. Now, I can foresee, for instance, a social studies teacher going into the internet to show a social media post or a news article or a video news reel of current events so that you can heighten the discussion with your class. I can also foresee as a science teacher using browser-based simulations such as FET. I use this a lot for physics to demonstrate concepts that are hard to replicate in real life, such as reflection or simulating a frictionless ramp. With the limitless potential of what you could show in your internet browser, you could definitely make your classes more relevant to students than ever before. Number 5. Extra cameras. Now, most teachers who give online lectures will be using their default computer webcam. While this thing works, it is a bit restrictive in that it would be very awkward for me to carry my laptop around just to demonstrate a certain view. In my case, I am lucky enough to even have possession of a DSLR camera to really enhance the quality of my video lectures. And I can definitely foresee this kind of approach when you want to show something to your class and make the lecture a little bit more immersive. For instance, if you're a drama teacher who wants to act out a certain scene so passionately, when you're a PE teacher, you could demonstrate home workouts. When you're an art teacher, you could demonstrate drawing techniques or artwork. Or when you're a science teacher like me, you could even use this to demonstrate home experiments that the students can do and have a bit of fun with. So these kinds of things can be done because you have an extra camera, and it will definitely make your classes more hands-on and more immersive for the students to watch. So There you go. Those were just 5 ideas by which you could use OBS in order to really level up on your own video lectures. As you could see, the students would really appreciate the fact that you could expand beyond the PowerPoint and even show them more immersive lectures by the use of OBS and multiple scenes. If you need specific tutorials by which I could show you how to set OBS up such that it covers the multiple scenes, please let me know in the comments below so that I can work on these tutorials. But with that, I really wish you luck in your own online video lectures, and happy teaching to us all teachers. Bye-bye!